Welcome students to session number 51 of chapter number 3 motion in a straight line. We are having revision sessions for it. Today's topic is relative velocity. Now I have discussed what is relative. Relative word comes when you are comparing two things. Relative words come when you are comparing two things. So relative velocity is nothing but time rate of position of object 2 with respect to object 1. If somebody asks you that there are two objects, if somebody asks you relative velocity of object 2 with respect to object 1, then relative velocity of object 2 with respect to object 1 when both are in motion is nothing but time rate of change of position of object 2 with respect to object 1. Time rate of position with respect to time. Remember dx by dt. Distance, time rate of change of distance, position, time rate of change of position, rate of change of position they are saying. Change in position is nothing but what? Displacement? Yes or no? So displacement upon time is going to give you what? Velocity. So time rate of change of position of an object with respect to time is going to give you velocity, which is known as relative velocity. Hope it is clear. Let me write the definition for relative velocity. The relative velocity of object 2, the relative velocity of object 2 with respect to object 1 when both are in motion, is time rate of change of, position of object 2 with respect to object 1. Clear? The rate of velocity of object 2 with respect to object 1 when both are in motion is time rate of change of position of object 2 with respect to object 1. Now I'll prove this. That how this relative velocity comes. Taking an example over here, if an object 1 is moving with constant velocity v1 and object 2 is moving with constant velocity v2. I am considering two objects. Object 1, object 2. Object 1 and object 2 are moving in same direction provided they are moving with constant velocities v1 and v2 respectively. So I can say this is my object 1 and this is my object 2. Clear? Both are moving in same direction with constant velocities v1 and v2. Till this clear? 100% clear? Okay. Now moving to the concept, if I want to let the positions of object 1 and object 2 at t is equal to 0 be. Clear? B, I am considering x1 0 and x2 0 respectively. Clear? Sir, what is x1 0, x2 0 means? x1 0, x is letter denoted for what? Position? 0 represent at 0 instant. T is equal to 0 seconds. So, if somebody wants to write t is equal to 0 seconds, then I can represent the displacement as x0, position as x0. I can represent position at x0. Clear? This is your initial position. Considered to be what? Initial position. So, let the position of an object 1 and object 2 at t is equal to 0 be x1 0 and x2 0 respectively. Then at time t is equal to t seconds. Means I need to determine what? Xt now. I need to determine xt. Now, there is one formula. We know that velocity that is equal to displacement upon time. Displacement is nothing but change of position. Displacement is nothing but what? Change in position. And change in position is nothing but final position. Final position minus initial position. Final position minus initial position is going to give you what? Displacement upon time taken. Clear? To perform this displacement. Now listen over here. Velocity that is equal to, your final would be at some time t. Your final would be what? At some time t or not? Yes or no? So I am going to write over here, that is xt minus your initial is x0, because your starting journey is what, t is equal to 0 seconds. So final minus initial divided by this final time instant minus initial time instant is 0. So my velocity v that is equal to xt minus x0 divided by t, I can say. Yes or no? Fine. So moving ahead, I do have equation that is velocity, that is nothing but vt, that is nothing but xt minus x0 divided by t minus 0. So I am going to get vt that is equal to xt minus x0, t minus 0 is going to be t. Yes or no? Now I am cross multiplying over here. So I am going to get this vt into t that is equal to xt minus x0. If somebody asks me the position at time t, so I can determine this by equation xt that is equal to, if I'll send over here, and it is x0 plus vtt. Clear? This is my general expression. Out of this, I can write for two objects. If I want to determine the position of two object one at time t, so I'm going to write that I'm writing it object one. For object one, I'm writing for object one, my xt. Object one, so I'm putting suffix one. X1t that is equal to initial position x1 0 plus velocity of object 1 is v1 and time is t. Till this clear perfectly? 100% clear? Fine, very good. So I am going to get over here that is x1t. If I send this side, that is minus x1 0 that is equal to v1t. This is my first equation that I am getting, equation number 1. Clear? Similarly, for object 2, if I am going to write, that is object 2. For object 2, again, that is x2t, this final position. Yes or no? Initial position is x2, 0. Yes or no? Plus, velocity is v2 for object 2. And time is again t. So, if I send this side, then I am going to get x2t minus x2, 0. That is equal to v2t. This is my equation number 2. Hope it is clear perfectly. Equation 1, equation 2. Clear? Equation is representing the relation that is xt, position at final time t, is equal to position at initial time plus v1 into v into t, respective velocity and time taken. From this relation, I got these two equations. Perfectly clear? 100%? Fine. So moving ahead. Okay, can we recall two equations? Just now I have derived the first equation we do have, that is x2t, x1t, yes or no? x1t that is equal to x10 plus v1t. This is my equation 1. There is another equation x2t that is equal to x20 plus v2t. That is my equation 2. Till this clear? I am writing over here, C over here, subtracting. Equation 1 from equation 2. Equation 1 from equation 2. So I am going to get x2t minus x1t. Actually, I am doing subtracting equation 1 from equation 2. Clear? So x2t minus x1t. Now, what is x2t first? x2t do I have? There is x20 plus v2t minus 1. I do have x10 plus v1t. Till this clear? This minus this is equal to this minus this. 100%? Fine. So I am opening this, that is x20 plus v2t minus x10 minus plus minus v1t. Till this clear? This is x2t minus x1t. Okay? Perfectly. And see, I am taking initial positions together. So it is x20 minus x10 plus v2t minus v1t. v2t minus v1t. I am here getting x2t minus x1t. Clear? Now 2 I am combining. So x2t minus x20. This is the first block I am making over here. First two object 2 taking into a separate term. Minus this x1. If I am taking out this minus x1t over here, this minus will become plus. But instead of it is minus, so I have to put what? Minus over here. Clear? is equal to, I am going to have v2t minus v1t. Clear? This is nothing but, again I am writing one more step, x2t minus x1, x20 minus x1t minus x10. That is equal to, if I will t common out over here, so my value is v2 minus v1. v2 minus v1, t common out. Till this clear perfectly? Hope it is perfectly clear, no doubt over here. 100%? Fine. So moving ahead to the next that we do have. Let me change the color of the pen. I got my last equation to be that is x2t minus x20, yes or no, minus x20 minus x10, and here I got v2 minus v1 into t. Till this clear? Perfectly fine. I think one thing over here, this is final position, this is your initial position. Final position minus initial position is nothing but what? Displacement. So I can write this bracket as what? Displacement of object 2 in time t, I can say. Yes or no? Minus. Again, final position minus initial position. Final position minus initial position is again nothing but what? Displacement of object 1 in time t, I can say. Here I am keeping a s, that is v2 minus v1 into t. Till this clear? Again, I already told you that relative velocity of object 2 with respect to object 1 when both are in motion is nothing but time rate of change of position of object 2 with respect to object 1. This is displacement of object 2 in time t minus displacement of object in time 1. Can I write this 2 as combined as displacement of object 2 with respect to object 1 in time t? Yes or no? If I'll combine this, I can say that displacement of object 2 minus displacement of object 1 is nothing but what? Relative comparison between two objects. So I can write as what? Displacement of object 2 with respect to object 1 in time t. That is equal to v2 minus v1 into t. Can I send this t downwards in the denominator? What I am going to get? Displacement of object 2 with respect to object 1 in time t divided by, I got this t. So my equation over here is v2 minus v1, term remaining. Till this clear? Displacement upon time taken is nothing but velocity. So I can write as relative velocity of object 2 with respect to object 1, that is equal to v2 minus v1. I got my answer, that is relative velocity of object 2 with respect to object 1 is nothing but v2 minus v1. So I can write one equation over here from this. Hope it is perfectly clear. I am getting more detail so that you can clear the concept very well. So I got relative velocity of object 2 with respect to object 1 that we got v2 minus v1. So this is, I can write a symbol v2 minus v1. Hope it is clear perfectly. If somebody asks you find out relative velocity of object 1 with respect to object 2, if this interchange, if somebody asks you to find relative velocity of object 1 with respect to object 2, that you need to determine V1 to 2-1, 2 minus 1. So 1-2, that is V1 minus V2. This is your answer. Hope you are clear with the concept of relative velocity. Fine. I'll solve two numericals today related to this theory, which are not given in your textbook, but for concept clearance. Clear? Okay, fine. Seeing to the first numerical we do have. Example one we are considering today, that is, listen carefully. A car A, we can consider car A is moving in a straight line. Moving in a straight line with velocity 10 meter per second. With velocity 10 meter per second, where A is ahead of B, A is ahead of car B, moving in same direction at velocity 6 meter per second. A car A is moving with velocity 10 meter per second. They have also mentioned that there is a car B moving in the same direction, where car A is ahead of car B and car B is moving at a speed of 6 meter per second. Find relative velocity of A with respect to B. Relative velocity of A with respect to B and vice versa. And vice versa. Clear? Means they're, in short, they're asking relative velocity of car A with respect to B and where relative velocity of car B with respect to A. This is the question. Now you have to keep in mind one thing over here, that car A is ahead of B moving with velocity 10 meter per second, car B in the same direction moving with velocity 6 meter per second. Is this clear? A is ahead of B. Perfectly fine. So if somebody asks you VAB, then VAB is nothing but velocity of A minus velocity of B. Remember, both are in same direction, though you have to take plus. The value of the velocity given would be plus in both the cases, as both are in same direction. If one of them is in opposite direction, then the one who is in opposite direction or moving in opposite direction will you have to take negative. Negative represents what? Opposite in direction. But here both given that both are moving in same direction, so value will be positive. Fine. So VA we do have, that is 10. VB we do have, that is 6. So your answer is 4 meter per second. So I got VAB 4 meter per second. I can conclude one thing over here. The driver of car B sees that the car A is ahead of him, is ahead of it with moving with 4 meter per second, is relatively ahead, moving at a rate of 4 meter per second. If somebody asks you VBA, then VBA that is equal to VB minus VA. VB minus VA, VB that is nothing but 6, VA is 10, so answer is minus 4 meter per second. So what does this mean? Minus 4 meter per second means driver of A, when looks behind B, when looks behind from his car, when driver A looks behind from its car, he sees that B is in the same direction, moving in the same direction towards A, where A is ahead of B and B is moving with a rate 4 meter per second, less rate of 4 meter per second than to his car. Clear? This is the conclusion for what? From here, A sees that B lags behind with a rate of 4 meter per second square. Here B watches A that A is ahead of B with a rate of 4 meter per second. Clear perfectly? 100%? Fine. So moving to the next example we do have, that is two trains of length 120 meter and 80 meter are moving in opposite direction. There are two trains. Their word important is opposite direction. At a speed of 42 km per hour and 30 km per hour. So if I want to calculate relative velocity, now they are moving in opposite direction. If they are moving in opposite direction, I told that you have to take 1 to be negative. So I'll take what? Relative velocity of one train. With respect to another. Clear? So I am taking first train to be 42 km per hour. Yes, minus second is moving in opposite direction. I am going to take its value minus 30 km per hour. So my answer is 42 plus 30. That is 72 km per hour. Hope it is clear. when it is moving in opposite direction, you have to take one negative. So your answer is going to be plus only. So you will put over here, that is relative velocity. If I need to relative velocity, if I want to calculate in meter per second, the 72 into 5 by 18 meter per second. So this is 18 for the 72. Yes or no? So my answer is 20 meter per second is my relative velocity. Clear? Now total distance traveled. Total distance traveled by each train to cross each other. So you need to calculate total distance to be traveled. Total distance to be traveled to cross each other. To cross each other. That is nothing but what? Both lengths? 120 meter plus 80 meter. Your answer is how much? 200 meters. Your answer is how much? 200 meters. Now they are asking what over here? How much time it will take to cross each other completely? They are asking how much time is taken. So we already know the formula. What is already known with the formula? That is relative velocity. That is equal to total distance to be traversed. Total distance to be traversed upon time taken. Yes or no? Therefore t, that is equal to what? 200 divided by 20. So your answer is how much? 10 seconds. Your answer is how much? 10 seconds. So here my answer is 10 seconds. Hope it is clear perfectly. Fine. Thank you.